Hello children, welcome back to our science class. Hope you are all doing great. We have crossed a big cyclone, Niver. Hope you have seen that, isn't it? So, in today's class, we are going to see a new topic regarding basic need. Yes, very good, water. So, our topic for today is water. Unit number 2. It is on page number 48 in your term 2, volume 2 textbook. So students, be ready with your term 2, volume 2 textbook. Take page number 48, unit 2. Water. In this topic, we are going to see the potable water, different sources of drinking water, methods to prevent wastage of water, the conservation of water bodies, methods to conserve water bodies, problem caused due to stagnation of water. So, our first topic is water. Water is one of the most important resources on earth. It is the primary source of life. All living things need water. Rain is one of the main sources of water. Potable water. Do you know what is potable water? Potable water is nothing but the drinking water. The water that is good to drink and useful for food preparation. That is called potable water. It should be free from dangerous chemicals, transparent, odorless and colorless, and also it is free from bacteria which causes diseases. So this is potable water. And the next topic we are going to see is the different sources of drinking water. Water is available in many natural resources, but not all the water resources are suitable for our purpose. Why? Because the water we must boil them to kill the germs. Then only it is suitable for drinking. A few sources of water are rain, well, river, lake and stream. Water is very precious, so we have to save them. Why should we save water? You know, only 3% of the water in the entire earth is fresh water. So water is very precious. So we should never waste water. So how can we prevent the wastage of water? Never allow water to overflow from buckets. Be careful, children. Never allow. You should never allow the water to overflow from buckets. Wash fruits and vegetables in a bowl of water and not under the running tap water. Always close the taps while brushing the teeth. Please follow the students. Always you have to close the taps while brushing the teeth. Use leftover water in your water bottle to water a potted plant. Turn off the tap after each use. Use a sprinkler to water the garden. You can use sprinkler. And what you must do, you have to turn off the tap after each use. By following these methods, we can prevent the wastage of water. I hope you will follow these methods because water is very precious, students. So we must save them. Okay, now the next topic is the conservation of water bodies. Yes, the next topic is the conservation of water bodies. Do you know what you mean by conservation of water bodies? Water conservation refers to the preservation, control, and development of water resources, both surface, groundwater, and prevention of pollutions. All the water that we get comes from rain. When it rains, some water will flow to the ground, giving rise to streams and rivers. What happened to some collected in low-lying areas, such as ponds and lakes? The flow of the river is blocked by building a dam across it. Some rainwater seeps into the ground as underground water, isn't it? So the first one is lake. Lake is nothing but a large area filled with water, surrounded by land. Next, pond. A pond is a body of a stagnant water, either natural or artificial. It is slightly smaller than a lake. Reservoirs, they are built in areas of low rainfall or in areas where there is no major river. Most of the reservoirs are built using stones. Can you name one? Satyamurthy Reservoir, located at Tiruvallur districts in Pundi village. Yes. And tanks. A water tank is a container for storing water for our daily use. We all having water tank in your home, isn't it? So, how can we conserve water bodies? Methods to conserve water bodies. Deepening of ponds and lakes. Plant trees at the bank of lake and pond. Reduce water pollution. Avoid digging too many wells in a region. So, by doing this method, we can conserve the water bodies. And the next topic we are going to see is the problem caused due to stagnation of water. Stagnant water can become a breeding ground for which insect? Very good, mosquitoes. Mosquitoes that transmit so many diseases to us. Malaria and dengue is the main, the dangerous diseases, as you all know, isn't it? And some waterborne diseases such as cholera, dysentery, typhoid are also caused by drinking unclean water. So children, keep in mind, you should always boil the water before taking in, okay? And now we are going to see one of the most dangerous, deadly disease, dengue fever. It is caused by a mosquito. It is how it formed. It breeds in a stagnant water. The symptoms of dengue fever: severe headache, rashes on the arms and the legs, extreme tiredness, sudden onset of fever that lasts 3 to 7 days. So children, be careful. You should wisely use the water, don't waste it. And keep in mind students, we should always boil the water. So, I hope you enjoyed this class children. You have learned a lot about the importance of water, isn't it? So, now I am going to tell you some few facts about this water. A camel can drink 60 to 100 liters of water at a time and live without water for several days. Wow. And the World Water Day is observed on 22nd March. So 22nd March is World Water Day. And each person on the earth requires at least 20 to 50 liters of clean and safe water per day for drinking and other activities. And do you know, in olden days, people stored water in different ways. Few methods are, well, water tank in forts, draw well, reservoirs, rivers and bunds, tanks, dam and bore wells. So children, daily you have to take your textbook and read, and this is one of the basic topic and an important one. You must follow this in your daily life. See you in the next class with different topic, children. Thank you.